In 1931, the Empire State Building became the world's tallest building. Now, 90 years later, its upgrades have made it truly an impossible science.
Hey everyone, it's Jason Latimer, world champion of magic, and we're here at the Empire State Building because I've been given secret access to learn how these people are making the impossible possible with innovation and sustainability. How cool is that?
Completed in 1931, the Empire State Building weighs a massive 365,000 tons. That's over 200,000 cars. That is 210 steel columns to hold up this weight.
How do you top off one of the world's tallest buildings? With a 200-foot Art Deco tower, complete with a lightning rod, which is a good thing, because this building gets hit by lightning roughly 25 times a year.
Lightning strikes carry enough electricity to create heat up to 5 times the surface of the sun, which makes lightning rods an extremely important component of skyscrapers like the Empire State Building. Because without them, you could have electrical fires, as electricity finds its way through conductive materials like wiring or even plumbing as it wreaks havoc through the building.
Since 1931, the Empire State Building has been a symbol for technology, imagination, and ambition. But not many people know that it's actually a leader in sustainability. What's sustainability, you ask? Well, that's a really good question, which is why I have Dana Robbins Schneider here, who's the director and SVP of energy and sustainability here at the building.
Sustainability in a huge sense is living in a way today that enables future generations to live at a higher quality of life, or at least the same quality of life than we've lived.
How did that become such a priority here at the Empire State Building? I mean, where did that initiative start?
That's been a priority since I started working with our CEO and president, Tony Malkin, in 2007. The biggest thing for us is to look at the whole building, right, and all the systems and the people and everything to get the deepest reductions we can.
So everything in the building is not
everything,
just windows.
Every single thing. We've looked at everything, the windows, the walls, the roof. We have the largest wireless building management system in the world in this building.
Oh, wow.
And we upgrade it constantly. And this is basically a super advanced algorithmic computer that it allows us to control all of the equipment.
But I did hear about a secret. I heard about the underground waterway.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
Everybody loves the underground.
What is that?
So the underground wind tunnels, they're 50 or 60 feet below grade, so they're always cool. So wind velocity is often 15, 20 miles an hour down there. Those wind tunnels still bring fresh, cool air to the lower levels of this building.
Let's go check out those wind tunnels. Wow, you can actually feel the temperature drop down here. This is the infamous wind tunnel, also known as the underground waterway. Now, it's wet down here because the groundwater is seeping through the walls and through the floor. Now, this was constructed originally to provide cool air to the lower levels of the building. Now, this is before air conditioning was invented, so this is impossible engineering at work. Careful, watch your step. It's kind of slippery down here. How much more efficient are these windows versus anything else?
So the window project is one of the coolest projects we've done. We have 6,514 windows.
Wow.
At the time, 2007, they were about 15 years old. And we thought, well, that's too new to totally replace and not be wasteful. We actually created a window processing area in the building. We take those two panes of glass and put them in the first two stations, which are cleaning and quality control stations. And then we put a pane of suspended coated film between them. The suspended coated film functions as a solar heat gain coefficient. And then once we have that little film sandwich, we seal up all the sides, again, all on the fifth floor of the building. And then once it comes through the oven, we inject a mixture of krypton and argon gas.
This is all here in the building?
Yes.
Okay.
Super cool. Krypton and argon are they're large molecules. They're heavy molecules and they help prevent convective heat transfer. So they keep the cooling in when we want the cooling in and the heating in when we want the heating in. We used over 96% of the existing windows when we did all that.
Oh, wow.
Can't leave that part out.
Yeah, look.
Right? So we reused 96%. We had no carbon footprint for moving windows around and quadrupled the performance. So it's a very great sustainability and energy efficiency story.
And to celebrate all the hard work that goes on with the staff of the Empire State Building, where they make the impossible possible every day with sustainability and innovation, I thought it'd be fun to create a magic trick that would only work for this iconic building.
Here, go ahead and sign your name right across the face of that card. All right, now watch carefully with your four hearts. Go ahead and push the button if you will. Watch. Watch carefully with the four hearts, right? If I take the card like this and I push it in here, watch carefully. With a simple cut. And a simple shuffle. Watch carefully. So I take the cards like this. Watch carefully. One, two. Watch this, watch this. Rwanda.
I'm so glad you got to join me on this incredible tour of this building. I want to give a huge thank you to Dana and all of her friends at the Empire State Building. Now, if you enjoyed this video and want to learn more about the building or even how to build a skyscraper at home, make sure you click the links below. And if you want to learn more about how to make the impossible possible, well, make sure you like this video and share it with your friends. And as always, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.
I think the Batcave's somewhere around here.